Good morning to all of you. Now we are going to start with the basic controls of the Android Studio. So let's start the Android Studio. So double click on the Android Studio icon. This is the latest version till date. So I'm using the latest version of Android Studio. Today we are going to see all the controls one by one and all the file system. So first we will start with the file system. So let's wait to load the Android Studio. Now let's start with the file system first one by one. Now when you click on the project, you will get the file system as per the project perspective. When you click on the packages, you will get all the file system as per the package perspective. So like this, you can open the file system as per your requirement of the perspectives. So I'm going to use the app. So first, that is the packages which are used in the Android, and second, that's a Gradle. Now what the difference between this Gradle and the packages? See, the Gradles are nothing but these are the file systems which are required the external libraries. For example, suppose I want any kind of external libraries, I can use the Gradle. It means in the Gradle I have to set the dependencies. So here we have to set the dependency, and this dependency is going to download automatically by the Android Studio. So let's start one by one with the file system first, and then again I'm going to come at the Gradle file systems. So here's first, that's a manifest folder. Now the first file, that is Android manifest. Now what is the use of this Android manifest is, whenever you are going to add the activity, that is the entry of the activity is present in the Android manifest file. So here is the activity and Android name is equal to dot main activity. So this is the main, this is the activity, second next activity. So whatever the files or whatever the designs you are going to make, for example, suppose when you go in the resources, when you go in the layout, you will get all the design XML files, and corresponding the Java files you will get in the Java package. So com.example.sitapp, that is the package. In this package you will get all the Java files. So whenever you are going to add any activity, the entry of that activity is embedded, or that is added automatically in the Android manifest file. Jeva apan ekad activity enter karto, jeva ekad activity, for example, samja mi project la right click marla, new ani activity, tyanantar mala samja jar ekad basic activity paje asel kiwa empty activity paje asel, tar itha mala activities naav daya lagel, mi jeva finish karen tyavela tyachi automatic entry hi Android manifest madhe hot aste. So Android manifest file contents, so this is the entry added for the main activity 4. This is the activity I have added right now, and the entry of this file is added automatically in the Android manifest file. So Android manifest file contents, whatever the Java files and whatever the XML files are added, the entry of each file, or we can say the entry of each activity, is present in the Android manifest. This is one. Second, suppose there are multiple files and you have to change the file system like this. Suppose there are 10 files and you want to run first file. So we have to specify which file should run first when we launch any application. So that is present over here. So suppose I want to run any activity as a first activity. So the main, whatever the intent, okay, so here the main activity, and inside the main activity there is intent filter. So main activity 3, that will be the first activity which is going to run when I'm going to run the application. Jeva apan ek 10 activities add karat asto, 10 activity screen add karat asto, tewa aplyala pahili screen konti run karayche ahe he tumhala indicate karav lagta. He je indication ahe, he indication apan Android manifest ya file madhe takat asto. Tar जेव्हा तुम्हाला इथे इंटेंट फिल्टर हा टॅग दिसतो, याच्यावरचा जो टॅग आहे ॲक्टिव्हिटीचा, हा जो ॲक्टिव्हिटीचा टॅग आहे, तर पहिलं तुमचा मेन 3 ॲक्टिव्हिटी ही फाईल पहिल्यांदा रन होईल. ओके, समजा मला जर दुसरी एखादी ॲक्टिव्हिटी रन करायची असेल, तर आय हॅव टू मेक द चेंजेस ओवर हिअर. सपोज आय वॉन्ट टू रन मेन ॲक्टिव्हिटी 4 ॲज अ फर्स्ट, सो आय वॉन्ट टू रिप्लेस हिअर ॲज अ 4. नाव वेन यू सेव्ह दिस यू विल गेट द एरर, आय एम नॉट रन इट ॲट बिफोर. So when you save this, you will get the error because there will be the entry of this activity also. So suppose I want to run activity 4. So activity 4 will be my first running file. Now you will get the error like this because there is a duplicate registration. So again I have to make over here the change like this. So here is no duplication of the file. So the main 4 activity, that will be first file it is going to run. So like this, suppose later you want to do any kind of change, you can change the file settings like this. So this is the one thing where you are going to use Android Manifest. Second, suppose I want to change the icons, okay, you can change the icons over here also. So suppose you have created one app and you want to give the symbol for the application or the app, you can make that symbol by using this IC launcher. So where you want to make this, when you go in the drawables, here is the IC, here you will get the IC launcher. So whenever you have any icon, or suppose you have any JPG file or a picture file that you want to set as an icon, you can set that as an icon also, but that entry should be over here. So like this, for many kind of purposes you can use Android Manifest file. So whenever you want to do any kind of settings, you can do in the Android Manifest file. Now there is two options, one that is text, second is merge manifest. So from here you can see how you are going to merge this. Again, suppose I want to use the Android manifest, suppose I don't know the tags, okay, you can add the tags also. Now suppose I want to use any kind of external interaction, for example, suppose I want to use the application for Wi-Fi connection, or suppose I want to use this application to send any SMS or any kind of hardware interaction. So in that case you want to make the some kind of settings. So in case in this, these settings should be added in the Android manifest file. So after application tag or before the application tag, you can use their settings. For example, suppose I want to create an application which is going to connect to the internet or which is going to connect to the Wi-Fi, then I want to use the permission, because internet, that is the SIM card, that is again hardware. Or suppose you want to use a Wi-Fi connection, again it is a switch hardware device, so you want to interact with this hardware devices. So whenever there is any kind of hardware devices, or whenever there is any kind of interaction with external resources, you want to make the permission. So how you are going to make this permission? So just you can use users permission, and here I want to use the permission as android.permission dot internet. So when I'm going to use this tag, it means that I want to use this application to allow to use internet from the mobile. Or suppose you want to use connect to the Wi-Fi, or suppose you want to connect to the location also, I can use the permission. So for example, I can use the same tag. And here just I want to access the location. So access find location or course location. So like this you can add the permissions. So this is the Android manifest file. So again I'm going to revise. जेव्हा आपल्याला एखादा हार्डवेअर डिवाइस कनेक्ट करायचं असेल, किंवा एखादा हार्डवेअर किंवा एखादा रिसोर्स बरोबर कम्युनिकेशन करायचं असेल, तेव्हा तुम्हाला परमिशन्स सेट करावं लागतील. ह्या परमिशन्स ॲप्लिकेशन जिथे टॅग एंड होते तिथे, किंवा ॲप्लिकेशन जिथे स्टार्ट व्हायचं आहे त्याच्या अगोदर तुम्हाला परमिशन सेट करावं लागेल. मी एक परमिशन सेट केले तर ते म्हणजे इंटरनेटसाठी. समजा माझं ॲप्लिकेशन हे इंटरनेटला कनेक्ट करायचं असेल तर मला परमिशन इथे सेट करावं लागेल, किंवा वायफायला कनेक्ट करायचं असेल तरी मला इथं परमिशन सेट करावं लागेल, किंवा जर मला लोकेशन ॲक्सेस करायचं असेल तरी मला परमिशन सेट करावं लागेल. सो दीज आर द परमिशन्स वी नीडेड. And this permission should be set first in the Android manifest file. So this is the use of the Android manifest file. Later when we see the programs, again we will come to know in what variety of ways we are going to use that this Android manifest file. Now the next folder, that is a Java folder. Now inside the Java folder, there is com.example.sit app. This is the package name. Now whenever you are going to add the the Java files or the activities, there are two in the activity. There are two files. One that is Java file. This Java file is added over here, and the corresponding layout should be in the layout folder. So all the Java files are present in the com.example.sit app. So this is the package inside the Java. So again, inside the Java, there are three packages. One for the actual Java packages. Second for the testing, and third is again testing purpose. Now I'm going to tell what the difference between these two packages. The first package you have already know, that com.example.sit app. In this package, you will get all the Java files related to all the layouts. Now the second package is com.example.sit app. Now whenever you are going to write the test cases for the hardware or for the instrument testing, you are going to write this inside this folder. So here you are going to write the test cases. Second is com.example.sit app. Now here you have to write the test cases related to your software. So the integration testing or unit testing. So in case of developer is going to write the unit testing. So developer is going to do the unit testing, and all the cases related to unit testing we have to write inside a com.example.sit app test. So here you are going to add the test cases. So for every particular class, for example, suppose now this is the main to activity. Now this is empty. Now I'm going to check where we have written the code. Now suppose I want to write a test cases for this file, then a particular test file should be added in the com.example.sit app test. Now this is in this folder. So here I'm going to write test cases. For example, suppose I have written the validation, for example, user.getText.toString.empty. So here the test should be in such a way that if the username is empty, it should give the error. So here we are going to write a test cases corresponding to each and every scenario. So you know that the unit test is written by the developer. So there are no testers who are going to write the unit testing. Also for the integration testing also, you have to write a test cases. So test cases are nothing but you have to check the validations. For example, suppose here I have written the code for username should not be empty. So here we want to write a test here. So for this logic here, we have to write a test case. So this is purely software test cases, unit test cases. Second is your example instrumented test cases. So this is related to the mobile devices. So here we have to write a test cases related to your Android devices. So here are the three packages. Now you have clear that why these packages are there, means why we have their automatic generation of the three packages. Next, that is a Java. Now here is the build config file. Now here again, whenever you want to debug, or whenever you want to create a versions for your app, you have to make the changes in the build config file. For example, suppose you have created one application, and that application has completed, and after a particular time interval, suppose same application has came for the maintenance purpose, then here we have to make the versions. So in the first version what we have done, in the second version what the changes we have done. So like this, you have to create a versions of the software, and this version should be added in the build config file. Now I'm going to talk about the resources. Now first is the drawable. Now if there are any kind of images, like a background image or the icon image or the image for the application, such all kind of images should be there in the drawable folder. जेव्हा एखाद्या ॲप्लिकेशनला आपल्याला इमेजेस पाहिजे असतील, तर सगळ्या इमेजेस आपल्याला ड्रॉएबल नावाच्या फोल्डरमध्ये आपल्याला टाकाव्या लागतील. सो whenever you want, you have any kind of images, you have to add in the drawable folder. Second, that's a layout folder. So here you will get XML, all the XMLs of the design. Now next there's a MIP map. Now in the MIP map you will get IC launcher. Now one more confusion was there. Here you have to give. Now we will see the resource folder, RES folder. Now RES, that is a resources folder. It contains the values MIP map, layout and drawable. These are the four folders. Now let's check all the folders one by one. Now first, that's a drawable. Now if you have any background image or anything foreground background, that XML is present over here. Second, that is a layout folder. Now layout folder, already you know, if you have any kind of layout, all the XMLs of the layout will be present in the layout folder. Second, that is MIP MIP map. Okay, so this folder contains the IC launcher and IC launcher round. Now what it contains, whenever you have any images, that all images will be present in the IC launcher folder. So all these PNG folders, all these PNG files, these are the images. So these images are, all these images are present in the IC launcher and IC launcher round. Now suppose you have any background image, or suppose you have any background or suppose you have any icon as a app icon, so that will be present over here. So MIP MIP map, this is the folder name, and IC launcher, so this is the file name. So that will be the icon for your application. Application name is SIT app. So like this you can add the images for your project or for your application icon. Second, that's the values. Now here are the XML, all these XMLs are related. For example, suppose I'm opening the string.xml. Now here you will get app name. So string name is equal to, so this is the key and this is the value. So all these resources are present as a key value pairs. So string name, and this is the app name, this is the key, and the corresponding value is this. So this is mapped in a XML file, that is a layout file, and in your manifest file also. So here address string, that is I'm going to use string XML, and app name, this is the key, and the corresponding value for this app name is present in the string.xml. So SIT app, this is the actual value. So when you run the application, the application name will be SIT app. And how it is going to mapped? This is going to mapped from the string.xml. So address MIP MIP map, IC launcher round. So this is the round icon for the application. This is the icon for the launcher, and the locations will be like this. So address, this is the file name, and this is the key name, and corresponding value is retrieved at the runtime. Address style, so when you go in the style folder you will get the style names. So item name is color accent, and this is the value. So this is again mapped over here, address style. And when you open any XML of the layout, here is also address color and color accent. So address color, that's a this XML, colors XML, and this is the key. Particular value is applied at the runtime. So these are the XMLs where all the values are stored in the key value pair. So suppose you want any background color, foreground color, or any color for the icons, you can add the colors over here, and this color is applied at the runtime to a particular XML by using this mapping. So this is for the colors, this for the dimensions, this for the references, this for the strings, and this for the styles. So always keep in mind that whenever you are going to apply any kind of color or any kind of value to a particular control, either you can use like this, otherwise you can directly apply the color also. For example, suppose I want to change the color over here, I can directly write color as a white. So that white color is applied to the background. So like this you can use a color also, but as per the coding conventions it is better to write a code like this. So same is applied for all the conventions. So these are the coding conventions. It is not necessary to write the code like this, but as per the coding conventions we have to use the conventions like this. For example, suppose I want to give a name. Okay, so input type is txt password. So I can write this id as, I can write in the strings.xml. now suppose I don't want to use a hard coded string like this, I can use the coding conventions. So in the strings.xml I can change this. So in the string.xml I can write a code for this one. So here is the enter password. So I'm going to change this. So here will be string name is equal to enter pass, and I want to write as the enter password. Now I have added the key value pair. This is I want to apply in the Android XML. So here is the enter password. Here I'm going to change this. So @ string slash enter pass. Now this enter pass, this is going to map with the string.xml, and enter password will be applied at the runtime when you run the application. So like this you can write a strings over here, and the corresponding key should be added and the value should be applied at the runtime. So same is applied for the colors, dimensions and styles. So either you can hard code it, otherwise you can write like this. So as per the coding conventions it is better to write a code like this. So this was about the basic, how we are going to write and how we are going to improve the coding. Now I'm going to talk about the gradle files. Now what are the gradle files? See, all dependencies are not present with the application. Or suppose sometimes I want to make the applications where I want to use external resources, or where I want to use the external libraries. So that external library should be added at the runtime, and this should be added in the gradle files. So when I'm going to apply for the entire project, there are two Gradle files. One that is build Gradle project SIT app and build.gradle module app. Now if you want to apply for entire project, you can add over here, and if you want to apply for the module you can add over here. So I'm going to start with the build Gradle this module. Now here is the dependencies. So if there is any external dependency, you have to add the external dependency over here. Whenever you are going to add or whenever you are going to remove the dependency, the Gradle files are automatically running and the Gradle files first refreshed. It means that if you add any external files or any external jars, or the implements, the any external files, that files is downloaded first and these downloaded files are added in the project. So this was about the Gradle file. So always keep in mind that if there is any dependency of your project, you have to first add the Gradle files. Now these Gradle files are downloaded when you run the application. Means when you are going to compile the application, first the Gradle is going to run and the Gradle is going to download the packages. These packages are automatically added to your project. So this was about the basic file structure of the Android. Now from next onwards we are going to start with the basic programming and the controls also. So this was end of the lecture. If you have any doubts, any questions, you can put on the comments. Thank you.